This is a quick demo of the new SQLite utils memory command. So what this command lets you do is run operations against a SQLite database. So you can do things like simple mathematics. If I add dash t on the end, I'll get that out as a table. You can run functions like SQLite version to see the version of SQLite that you're talking to. But where this gets interesting is when you start combining it with data in CSV or JSON format. This is the GitHub API for returning the repositories belonging to a specific user or organization. As you can see, it's a JSON list of objects. So I can grab this here, and I can pipe it into SQLite utils memory and use the hyphen here to say, take what's being piped into you, and I can start running SQL queries about it. I'm going to say select full name, comma, stargazers count from studin and add dash t, and here we go. This is a list of all of those repositories and the number of stars they've got. I can say stargazers count as stars, stargazers as stars from studin ordered by stars desk. And now I've got a list of those repositories ordered by the ones with the most stars. And if I want to, I can say, you know what, I'm going to put this in a scientific paper written in LaTeX, and say dash dash format LaTeX, and get back the LaTeX code for that table. If I use format GitHub, I get back the GitHub markdown code that used for that. So this is a very quick way of taking, in this case, JSON, slicing and dicing it, reordering it, and then outputting it in a bunch of different formats. I can use dash dash CSV to get it back out as CSV again. All sorts of different options like that. So that's running this command just against data that I'm piping from somewhere else. But where it gets really fun is when you start joining data together. I'm going to use two data sources here. And this is data that the CDC publish on an undocumented API showing the progress of vaccination across the different states. So I'm going to grab a copy of this. One problem with this is it's the wrong shape. The SQLite utils likes arrays of objects, but this has a wrapping thing around it. So what I'm actually going to do is grab that, pipe it through JQ to get back just these vaccination data key, and write that to a file called vaccinationdata.json. And then if we do more on that, there we go. That's the kind of data that we want. And then the New York Times have been publishing COVID data around the number of cases and deaths in a CSV file on a GitHub repository, usstates.csv. So I'm going to grab a copy of that as well. So now I've got those two files. I've got a JSON file and I've got a CSV file. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a SQL query I prepared earlier, just so you don't have to watch me type it. What this is going to do is take that CSV data and that JSON data, load it into this in-memory database, and then T1 means the first table, and T2 means the second table, so we're going to do a join that combines data from those two tables. So if I put this in like that, this is now giving me back a table showing for each state the number of, as of the most recent date, number of cases and number of deaths, according to the New York Times, and the census population, and the vaccine distribution per 100,000 people, according to the CDC. So we've just done something pretty sophisticated. We've combined CSV data from the New York Times, JSON data from the CDC, and we've done it essentially with a single shell script one-liner. If you want to know more about this, the software, I released this tool just this morning. The documentation here covers all of the other options, including ways you can further join this data against data you might already have in a SQLite database file. I'm really excited about this as a way of doing sort of even faster scripted ad hoc data analysis across different sources of data.